So the cold rains were over, and the fog would soon be drifting away. I took some time to enjoy this peaceful morning.
So, finally, the rain should be over with, and we should be done with the miserableness of what was the cold rain. There's gonna be rapids right down there, left of that island, which you can't see because it's really foggy right now. Today, we need to make a minimum of 18 miles to put us in a good spot to take out on Monday. So excited to move this trip along today without the rain. So it's morning day three here, getting ready to put off here in probably the next 10 or 15 minutes. I went ahead and got in my boat because I was ready. Brian is finishing up. So today we got to make about 18 miles at least. And in that we have a dam portage coming up here in about 14 miles-ish. So there's Brian over there. He's getting ready to put in. So, look forward to this day ahead.
So we set off, heading left of a big island just ahead. The island expected to have multiple Class 2 rapids and Class 1 rapids scattered throughout the island. It was the excitement I was ready for.
That's a hell of a way to start.
So this island is what I had pegged as a campsite, but I'm glad we chose what we did because I'm not seeing anywhere to even take out. Maybe there's something at the end of the island.
One thing we noticed early on was the current was a nice steady 3 to 4 miles an hour. This made the paddle really easy and enjoyable. As we paddled, I noticed the scenery was changing. The rock bluffs were slowing down. Still great views, it was just getting a little different. It was like an oasis, and it was put there just for us.
Thank you. portage.
Yeah, you're right. So the seed was set, or at least the idea was out there. We probably actually could finish before dark. That's a lot of miles though.
It is. Yeah, it also depends on how
the current
miles of fuel.
Yeah.
I figure we'll get to the gas station and we'll see what time it is then. How the current is and what the fuel is depending on. We really think we want to.
I don't either, but we'll see.
So we're coming up on the dam here that we need to portage on the right. Should be about a 100-yard portage
Hopefully it's not too difficult. We will see here shortly.
So we came upon the ramp, scouted real quick, and then started the portage. I know I've said it before that other portages were the easiest I'd, but seriously, good luck finding a portage easier than this one. As we noticed, before we did the portage, they had actually removed the dam, and we considered running it. We decided that we weren't going to risk it anyway. We were just going to portage it, because it was easy, and it was smart. We finished getting our boats in position, and within 20 minutes of taking out of the water, we were putting back in. And ahead were the best looking rapids of the trip.
That was good.
The bridge ahead marked the 18th mile of the day and the 46th mile of the trip, and a gas station if we wanted it. We decided to move ahead. Shortly after, we came across the Mayo River. Took a quick peek, and downstream we continued. The miles just kept fading, and we were realizing we very well may finish this trip today. The current was still great, and the temperature, we just couldn't have asked for anything better. The paddle, it was just plain nice. Before we knew it, we only had 10 miles left to the takeout, and we just kept paddling. Thank you. I've paddled long days before. Today, yes, it was long mileage-wise, but it didn't feel long to the body. It was just an enjoyable day on the river, with great current all day long. Made the paddle easy, and made us want to keep going. It forced our hand into not finding a campsite for day three, but rather going all the way to the end, to the Leaksville Landing takeout, and the end of our journey, which in turn was the end of a 36 and a half mile day on the Dan River. We paddled 65 miles over the course of 3 days, filled with tremendous views, fantastic rapids, great current, cold rains, and a variety of other things that we got to enjoy during our trip. If you have the opportunity to make this trip, this expedition, I recommend it. Today, we spent over 8 hours on the water, and the only time we stopped was to portage the dam. Other than that, it was downriver we went.
All right.
And another ending to another great expedition.